Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. On this episode, let me show you how you can chart non-consecutive data in Numbers. So say you have some data in Numbers that has a set of dates, but they're not consecutive. Here you can see I've got January 6th, 7th, 8th, and then skip to the 15th and the 18th and then the 30th. I was asked this question recently by a viewer of how do you create a chart for this where the chart doesn't just treat everything equally. Let me show you. If I select this data here, I'm going to select all and hit chart and say I want a line chart. You can see each point is treated equally. The 6th, the 7th, the 8th, 15th, 18th, and 30th. It doesn't spread this out over a month like it should. These three should be grouped closely together and these two somewhat closely together, and there's some big gaps here. How do you get it so that this spreads over the month evenly? And it turns out a lot of people have had this question and not many solutions or any solutions really how to do this in Numbers. But you can do it in Numbers. It's not easy, but you can do it. And the way to do it is to create another sheet that actually has all the dates in it. So for instance, let's go to sheet 2 and you can hit plus button to create sheet 2. I'm going to create a simple table here and I'm going to put date and weight. And this makes sense. This is kind of a weight loss thing because you might not get a chance to weigh yourself every day. So I want to start off with the 1st of January, and then I'm going to have the second one here be a formula where it's the previous day plus 1. So that's the 2nd of January, and I could paste it here, paste it there, and keep pasting. As a matter of fact, I'm going to shrink this table this way and I'm going to grow it to be an entire month. So 32 days. Let's get that right around there. 32 because the first one is the header there. I'm actually going to paste for all of these. Paste it in. So now I've got 1-1 to 131. Now I could go and fill in the dates or the weights right here. So I could go back here and say okay 1-6 was 180, and I could go fill it in and leave the ones I don't know blank. But I'd like to have that done automatically. I mean, what if this was a year's worth of dates or 2 years worth? It would be easy enough to fill these in there just as I did before by copy and paste. But how do you fill in all the bits of data? So as with most things in Numbers, it's going to be formulas to the rescue. So how do we do formulas for this? Well, we can use a formula here. I'm going to hit an equal sign and I'm going to use the VLOOKUP formula. And I found this by just searching through here and reading descriptions. And the VLOOKUP formula allows me to look up data in another table. So I'm going to do VLOOKUP. There we go, VLOOKUP. And the first parameter is going to be what to look up. So I'm going to look up the date that's here to the left. The second parameter is going to be the set of rows, the whole range of cells that I want to look up. So I'm going to actually stretch across these two columns here. The third parameter would be which of the columns should hold the data that gets returned. So it's the second column, the weight here. And then I can see here there's another one here for what to do if there's a close match. I'm going to set that to false. Just return an error. So now I get 180 because it looks up here and it says 1-6 is 180. If I were to copy this and paste it in all of the cells here, I get a lot of errors and the correct ones for the dates it has. So the 6th, 7th, and 8th, 180, 180, 178. 115 should be 174, and sure enough it is. So now I've got a table that automatically fills up with data based on this data here. If I add more to this, it will reflect it. So for instance, if I were to insert another row, because I found out I had this data, I can now see that 177 is automatically filled in there. So if I extended this out to be all the way to the end of the year, for instance, and then I kept adding more to this table would automatically grow. So now let's turn this into a chart. I'm going to select the entire table and I'm going to turn it into a chart. I'm going to do a line chart here, and you can see now it actually correctly scatters things across. See, there's the big gap between the 18th and the 30th. These are consecutive. So that basically gets me what I want. I would like it to be a little neater in that I've got lines between these dates because they're consecutive, and then it breaks the lines here because there's just errors for these dates. So some experimentation told me that I could, if I go from 2D line to 2D area, it actually fills things in very nicely. So one of the things I want to do here is I want to change the minimum value, as I should, to 0, so it makes more sense. 0 and 180, so everything's represented normally here. And you can see it actually follows along really nicely, filling in the gaps. I can select this area here, go into Style, and tell it I want you to have a line at the top but no fill. And now I've got a nice line exactly the way I want it. It doesn't show anything down here, it just shows the line at the top, and it fills in all the gaps, and I get a really good sense of all the data going across, even though there are blank spots. So that's how you do it, and that's how you make it so it goes and you can fill a graph in with non-consecutive dates. I'm going to cut that, Command X, and paste it into here, because now I can actually use this chart here, ignore this in the background, and if I add a new date, like for instance, let's add another one, and you can see it added automatically to this chart. So I can just forget about this working in the background and use this and get the result shown here.